Hi, good morning everyone, and welcome to worship. Hi everyone, good morning and welcome to St Andrew's Online. We're a church based in Sedgley in the West Midlands in the United Kingdom. We're a Methodist URC and this is our first attempt at an online video service. As a lot of you know, over the last few months we've been recording audio services and getting those distributed, which have gone down really, really well. So we now feel it's time that we can start hopefully putting some video services together for you. The service this morning will be led by our minister Barry. The songs have been recorded for us by Ian Holmes, and Susie will be doing the reading for us. So please like the channel, click on the like button below and subscribe. If you subscribe, you'll get notifications as soon as new videos are uploaded. So we hope you're all well. We hope you're all looking after yourselves in this strange time that we're having at the moment. And we're hoping and praying that we will be able to meet again in the church in the next few months. But the key thing is to stay safe. So please sit back and relax. Just take the next minute just to focus. There'll be some music playing, Speak O Lord, just to prepare ourselves for this morning's worship. So we hope you enjoy it. Take care.
Speak, O Lord, as we come to you to receive deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory.
Welcome everyone to our service on Pentecost Sunday. Let's listen to or sing the hymn, Spirit of God, Unseen as the Wind.
Help us believe, show us the Savior's love. spoke to us long, long ago, gave us the written word. We read it still, needing its truth. Through it, God's voice is heard. Help us believe, show us the Savior's love. Without your help, we fail our Lord. We cannot live His way. We need your strength, following Christ each day. Spirit of God, unseen as the wind, gentle as is the dove, teach us the truth and help us believe, show us the Savior's love.
And let us come to a time of prayer. Let's pray. Gracious God, for the Spirit of peace that calms our minds and stills our life, we praise you. For the Spirit of love that touches hearts and reaches out, we praise you. For the Spirit of joy that lifts our soul and gives us faith, we praise you. For the Spirit of power, that gift of grace for this your church, we praise you. And as we praise you, we ask for your forgiveness, Lord, when we forget that the power is yours and we trust instead upon our own human strength. Remind us of that glorious day when your Spirit transformed the lives of those who hid in fear into people of power. Renew these hearts which have grown cold with flames of fire, as on that day of Pentecost, that we might be the church that you desire. Amen.
Our reading this morning is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 to 21. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. Now, there were staying in Jerusalem God-fearing Jews from every nation under heaven. When they heard this sound, a crowd came together in bewilderment because each one heard their own language being spoken. Utterly amazed, they asked, "Aren't all these who are speaking Galileans? Then how is it that each of us hears them in our native language? Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya near Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. We hear them declaring the wonders of God in our own tongues. Amazed and perplexed, they asked one another, "What does this mean?" Some, however, made fun of them. "They have had too much wine." Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and addressed the crowd. "Fellow Jews, and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These people are not drunk as you suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. No, this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in the heavens above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Amen.
Today is Pentecost Sunday, a day to celebrate when the Holy Spirit was first given to the disciples of Jesus, the day many people call the church's birthday. I was struck when I saw some paintings of the Holy Spirit on an internet site recently. Most of them were quite serene, depicting the Spirit as our comforter. I've also noticed that when many people speak about the Holy Spirit, they talk about how God puts a thought into our heads and gives us divine but gentle nudges. The Holy Spirit seems to be seen as very gentle, bringing peace to our lives. But when we read the biblical account of Pentecost, we get a very different view of the Spirit. Loud and fiery seem more appropriate descriptions. In fact, the Holy Spirit is earth-shattering, like a violent wind, filling an entire house in a moment, divided tongues of fire. Luke, who wrote Acts, uses words like suddenly, rush, violent, wind, fire. There's nothing subtle or quiet about the Spirit there. The Holy Spirit arrives loudly and dramatically and set the disciples on fire, so to speak. They were never the same after that day, and neither was the world. The Spirit brought about radical transformation in many people. On the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit transformed a gathering of the disciples into the body of Christ, the church. So, impulsive Peter, competitive James and John, meek Mary, questioning Thomas, all of them are changed. Some become prophets, some healers, some preachers, some carers. Some would travel the known world, spreading the good news of Jesus Christ. And many more would be in the background, giving support whilst caring for the poor. But let's be clear, everyone in the biblical account is fired up by the Spirit and filled with the power to help change the world. It would have been great to be in church together today, celebrating Pentecost, but it's not to be this year. My intention had been to reflect upon what the Holy Spirit's been doing here in the life of St. Andrew's during our first 50 years. An incredible amount of good worship and prayer, fellowship and learning, mission and evangelism, generosity, pastoral care, community involvement, work with children and teenagers, and so much more. It's been 50 wonderful years. And my intention was to reflect upon all of that and invite everyone to believe that God has not finished with us and there's much more to do. I wanted to challenge everyone to join in praying for guidance and strength, courage and all the gifts we need to do what God wants us to be doing. It is a rotten time at the moment. We can't worship in our church building. We can't get on with all the things we want to be doing for God. We want the community cafe and the church shop to be open. We want our various groups to be meeting. We want to be in the school. We want to be putting into action the things that we believe God has given us as visions for the future. And let's be honest, besides the frustration, there is fear that things might take a very long time to get back to where we want them to be. So has the fire burnt out? Has the wind stopped blowing? Has a virus taken the confidence and life out of the church? Where's the fire that fills us with confidence and determination? I met a member of another church recently who said to me that she wished she could be filled with the Holy Spirit. She'd been listening to a Christian TV channel on Sky, and the preacher had said that if you were a true Christian, you'd be filled with enthusiasm and energy. You'd speak in tongues and bring lots of people into the church. I so want to be like that, she said. The thing is that she is a very prayerful lady who reads her Bible and reflects upon it every day, who does her bit in the life of her church according to her circumstances, and she is kind and generous, forgiving, and as Christ-like as anyone I know. Her life is filled with the Holy Spirit, but she couldn't see it. The Spirit works in many different ways in all of our lives. Sometimes the Spirit blesses us with gifts we've never dreamt we'd have. Sometimes the Spirit shakes us out of our complacency and makes us much better disciples. Sometimes the Spirit takes our lives and sets off in a new direction that we'd never dreamt of. Who'd have thought that that quiet woman who used to sit at the back of this church and rush out after a service would be about to begin training for diaconal ministry? Not many people could see it. Susie couldn't see it. But God saw it and did all that was necessary, blessing her with many wonderful gifts along the way. Sometimes the Spirit fires us up and sometimes calms us down. Sometimes settles us, sometimes brings us peace, and sometimes builds up our confidence. That's the thing about the Spirit. The Spirit does what the Spirit wills, not what we tell the Spirit to do. And as we go through a period when we can't stop ourselves worrying about the future of our denominations and the local churches, Pentecost is a powerful reminder that we will not face the future by ourselves. We should open our hearts and minds to the power of the Spirit that can calm us and give us vision, bless us with gifts and lead us to a good place. I'll confess that I've been feeling a bit down at times during this lockdown, wondering what's ahead of us, fearing it's all going to be a bit too hard. But Pentecost reminds me, like all of us, that we do not face the challenges alone. There will be tough decisions to be made. Some churches will conclude that their mission is complete and it's time to move to be with other churches. Some activities in our church will not be the same and some will not be possible. But Pentecost reminds us that we have a powerful and dynamic God who is not weakened by our lack of trust. God's already at work. God never stops working. God is filling us with ideas for ways forward and keeping us calm and keeping us strong in faith. The power of the Holy Spirit is greater than we can imagine and more than enough to give us hope and confidence that all will be well. All we need to do is open ourselves to the glorious Spirit. The Spirit will find a new normal for us, new ways of doing things and new things to do. There'll be grieving for what we have to let go of, but rejoicing when we see the new shoots rising as they will. The Spirit will make us do crazy things, like loving our enemies, reaching out to people who are outcasts in our society, making us spend our money differently, caring about justice. The Spirit will make us cry for the suffering of others and make us want to change the world. Some people thought the disciples were drunk on the day of Pentecost. Well, we should be drunk, not on alcohol, but in love. Drunk with love for God, full of compassion for others, extravagant in our kindness, and radical in inclusive and non-judgmental love for all people. So let's be thankful for the coming of the Holy Spirit, and let's live consciously in the Spirit, full of hope and confidence and trust, and most of all, full of love for God and all whom God loves. Happy birthday, Church. Amen. And so we come to our prayers of intercession. And when I say, Holy Spirit, hear us, I invite you to join me in saying, come, Holy Spirit, come. So let's pray. Holy Spirit of peace, we pray for homes and nations where there is discord and conflict. Pour out your breath of peace, that people may listen to each other and respect one another and honour each other. Holy Spirit, hear us. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit of hope, we pray for those who live in despair, for those who can see no purpose in their lives, for those who cannot see a way ahead, for those who feel completely alone. Holy Spirit, hear us. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit of unity, we pray for your Church, for its ministry to the faithful and its mission to the world. May the Spirit of Pentecost breathe upon us, that we may witness to the world the comfort, meaning, and love that you offer. Heal our differences and make us one in you. Holy Spirit, hear us. Come, Holy Spirit, come. In the name of our Saviour Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Let's join in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And so we listen to or sing the hymn, There's a Spirit in the Air. And so may the power of the Spirit challenge us. May the peace of the Spirit comfort us. May the presence of the Spirit enable us to live in love and service in the name of Christ. And may God's blessing be upon us and all whom God loves this day and forever. Amen.
What is our hope in life and death? Christ alone, Christ alone. What is our only confidence? That our souls to Him belong, who holds our days within His hand. What comes apart from His command, and what will keep us to the end? The love of Christ in which we stand. Oh, see.